It is as though, dear one, your ego is casting a thick shell over your perception. And this shell fogs your vision. This shell muffles your sound. This shell distorts your feelings. And as you, dear ones, work to remove this shell, you will find that you see things more clearly. It is not that your vision, your measurable vision, will improve, but instead that you will notice more things. You will begin to see more things happening around you, and you will understand your perceptions more clearly. Likewise, dear one, as you choose to purify the ego personality, you will find yourself hearing more clearly. You will understand more clearly what people are communicating with you. It is not only that your sense of physical hearing will improve, but also you will understand the messages that people are speaking in their words beyond the words they choose to communicate with. You will, dear one, begin to perceive their emotion as communicated through the etheric fields of sound. You will begin to understand the deeper message that they are speaking to you that may at times be different than the actual string of words they are speaking. You, dear ones, by casting off your emotional layers, will begin to feel the emotions within you that were formed by your past, often through traumatic experiences, for those are that which we hold on to most heavily. For those are that which we fear most deeply. Also, dear ones, in this moment, you will feel more accurately the emotional energies of those around you. You will feel how their subconscious mind is controlling their perception of this present moment. And you will notice this same behavior arising within yourself. Understand, dear ones, that the more you work to stay in awareness, the more you disempower the personal ego. So begin by silencing thought. Were you, dear ones, able to remain in the state of silence? How long until the first thought appeared? What was the comment made by this first thought? Was this first thought even necessary? Are you still in the state of silence now? And so, dear one, the path to true spiritual awakening can be measured by two factors. First is the degree of silence in your mind. This is determined by the lessening of thought. For as you stay in meditative awareness in every moment, you will find the speed at which your mind thinks decreasing. You will find the amount of thoughts decreasing. You will find the volume of thoughts decreasing. You will, dear ones, find that your thoughts have less pull on your attention. There will come a time when you can stay in this present state of awareness and simply hear the thoughts within your mind while still staying present. You will not be pulled into these thoughts, losing awareness of the greater state of what is happening within you and around you. The second factor, dear ones, that you can use to judge your own spiritual awakening is that of divine love. It is, dear one, the experience of bliss occurring within you. For as you can continue to surrender your own personal identity more and more, you will find yourself experiencing more fully your oneness with all of life. And as your experience of yourself expands, as you lose your identification with an isolated, separate, suffering human being, and as you experience yourself more fully as the divine creative consciousness, you, dear one, will find a supreme happiness radiating as your own self. This bliss, dear ones, is the state of union with all of life. It is the merging of the personal self with the universal self. It is the experience of life force energy, of oneness, of peace in eternity. And so, dear ones, silence within the mind is the pathway. Bliss as yourself is the pathway. Focus upon these two and allow them to purify most effectively the layers of your thinking mind. Create silence. Create oneness. Create bliss and peace. Create, dear ones, a fuller experience of that which you are in this present moment. Be here, right here. Do not allow your mind to pull you into some imagined reality. Do not allow your subconscious to pull you back down within it. Stay in the state of consciousness. Stay present right here. Regardless of what is happening, if nothing is happening, or if many things are happening, do not be concerned. Simply stay here. When new thoughts arise, stay here. If you get distracted from your thoughts, come back to this moment and stay here. You, dear ones, are this moment. You are, dear ones, the perception in which this present moment is occurring. You are the field of consciousness. You are the flow of life force energy. You are, dear ones, right here and right now. Be this awareness. Practice removing thought, silencing thought. Practice becoming detached from any and all thoughts within your mind. And allow your heart to lead you. Allow your heart to guide you throughout life. There is a far greater intelligence, that is you, that can guide this lifetime. It does not come through the socially conditioned thoughts of our mind. It does not come based upon the conditioning that we have accepted during our lifetime. This greater intelligence, dear ones, is the universal. And as you strengthen this connection to your deeper inner self, to your higher self within, you will find this universal consciousness guiding you and leading you more fully. Trust within yourself, dear ones. Practice removing the distracting thought. Practice lifting the veil of the ego self. Practice creating inner silence so you can perceive more accurately what is happening around you, so you can feel more accurately the emotions in your body and in the lives of others. Open yourself to this present moment, dear ones. Allow your inner self allow your higher self to shine through more fully. The pathway, dear ones, is the removal of thought, the silencing of mind, and the opening of heart. Let the divine love within guide you. Let the divine love within purify you. Let the divine love within radiate out from your being and bless this world. So, dear ones, how many thoughts did you have? Did you count the number of thoughts in this moment of silence? You, dear ones, must stay awake, not only during the periods of meditation, but in every moment throughout your life. Namaste.